Hello, this is Sanjay Sane from Sane's Academy of Statistics. In this video, we are going to see binomial distribution, one example related to binomial distribution, and one Python option regarding that. Well, binomial distribution states that, well, the PMF is nck, p raised to k, and q or 1 minus p raised to n minus k. That is what is our binomial distribution with mean and variance as mentioned, where p is probability of success, q is probability of failure, n is number of trials, and k is kr, number of successes. Well, let us see one example regarding that. Well, over here we have one example of insurance agent. This insurance agent is having a past record of success rate of 0.25, one in four customers convert. Now we are considering right now the problem in which he considers some interviewing some 40 potential customers, and among 40 potential customers, how can be his success rate probably? So one question is, probability, what is the probability that exactly five customers he converts or he makes them to buy the insurance? With the probability, the second question is probability that at most 10 customers he actually convinces. Number three, that at least 20 he convinces, and fourth one is regarding the moments or mean and variance we need to find out this particular distribution. Okay, so here we have now opened our Jupyter notebook, Python notebook. For that, the link of this Python notebook, which is in my particular GitHub account, will be mentioned in the comment section in the YouTube video. Well, to begin with, we need to do one import. So we need to first of all import binom module from scipy.stats. Now in our binom module we have a function PMF. Well, basically PMF function is regarding our function which has been mentioned in one of my slides over here, binom.pmf. Well, this function, let me tell you, applies for the scenarios when we need to find a probability that x is equal to k. In the tasks when we need to find probability x less than or equal to k, it is basically called cumulative distribution function. We will be using the probability CDF. When we want to find x greater than k kind of, then we will be finding out the probability with SF function, and finding mean variance and other moments we require the function stats. Coming back to the Python notebook, so with PMF and the values plugged in, we get the probability. The next task is we want to find probability. We want to find probability that not more than 10 customers actually buy, at most 10 customers buy life insurance from this agent. So CDF, with CDF, you know, because this kind of scenario we want, that's why the probability x less than or equal to k. Okay, CDF. And we have the answer regarding that. The next task of our problem is finding the probability of at least 20 customers that will buy insurance. Now, when we are talking about 20 customers, at least 20, basically, let me tell you what is at least 20 in our context. At least 20, it is probability x greater than or equal to 20. That means probability x is equal to 20, or probability x is equal to 21. Likewise, probability X is equal to 40. Why 40? Because at most he is going to interview 40 customers. One alternative is you summing up all the PMF function calls, some 20, 21, 20 up to 40. Another alternative is, you know, you writing down 1 minus that probability X less than or equal to 19. How come? Well, you see 0, 1, 2, 3 up to some 19, some 20, 21 up to some 40. You know, you want to find this particular probability. Okay. Now your CDF function gives you this probability. Okay. So if you happen to use CDF function, find out this probability, as you know that sum of all these probabilities is going to be 1 by our rule of probability density function. And that's why we may use the function as 1 minus CDF. Well, but I can recommend you, instead of using 1 minus CDF, you can use the function SF. Coming back, so SF, you use function SF, k is equal to n, n is equal to 40. Well, and you get the answer, or 1 minus CDF, as I was telling you, you can do that. And for moments, you can access the function, you can call the function dot stats, and you get the answer. So that's it from me for this particular task of finding the binomial probabilities using the Python option of binom.pmf.cdf.sf and dot stats. For more videos from me, don't forget to subscribe my channel, and also for getting more updates from me, don't forget to click the bell icon. Thank you.